Welcome to the fascinating and rapidly growing world of LEDs, light-emitting diodes, our first 21st century lighting technology. LEDs, and here's an example of one designed to replace incandescent lamps, are rapidly replacing older 20th century technologies in many commercial applications. Inside this LED replacement lamp is one of these, actually, several of these, a small-scale light-emitting diode. It's similar to the semiconductors that are inside your cell phone and your computer, except that these semiconductors emit light when electricity passes through them. Depending on how they're made up, the light can be blue of various colors, green, amber, orange, or red. What it can't be by itself is white. To make an LED white, you have to convert one of the other colors, in this case blue, to white, as we do here. Right? Using a material called phosphor, we convert some of that blue light to white. Here's a large-scale example. White light begins as blue light. The phosphor converts it to white. The LEDs are typically grouped together in an array of several LEDs together to provide sufficient quantity of light to fulfill our requirements. However, they can't operate on normal electrical supply at 120 or 277 volts. They need low voltage supply on a direct current, such as you would receive from a battery. To convert, we use a device called a driver. Here's one from a light fixture. Here's one built into a replacement lamp. And here is a really tiny one built into this size of replacement lamp. In addition to the LED array and the driver, there are also optics to control the light into the beam that we want. Yep. Due to the small size of the LED source, we can control it very precisely. See the light on the wall? Watch what happens when we put a lens over it. The optic transforms it into a tight spot. Finally, LEDs are vulnerable to heat. If we don't remove some of that heat, the output drops off dramatically and the LEDs cease to be useful. So we can use a cast heat sink whose mass will help us evacuate the heat from inside where it will harm the LEDs, or we can use more sophisticated designs such that we can use multiple surfaces to help air currents remove the heat. In either way, we need to cool the LEDs or they won't long be useful to us. LEDs offer several important advantages, the most significant of which is their efficiency. They are 4 to 5 times as efficient as incandescent sources, a little bit more efficient than fluorescent or HID lighting. And the light sources last a long time, 10 to 20 times as long as incandescent and slightly longer than fluorescent or HID lighting. Unlike fluorescent sources, LED likes to operate in the cold, and unlike HID sources, it dims easily. LEDs are also environmentally friendly. They emit no ultraviolet or infrared radiation, and they contain no mercury. There are, however, several challenges to using LED lighting. First, LED sources don't like to operate in high heat environments. Their electronics present some difficulties when dimming, and it can be expensive on an initial basis to get enough of them together to be useful in a high brightness environment. Today, LEDs have already become the predominant light source in such applications as refrigerated display cases and colored lighting effects. They're rapidly making inroads in retail display and outdoor lighting and are being seriously considered for such other commercial and institutional applications as offices and schools. But perhaps what's most exciting is what LED lighting can do to the way we experience light. It can make light that is warm, that is cool, that changes back and forth. It can make interesting colored lighting effects. Beams can be very compact or very diffuse. The horizons are completely open.